the northeastern Oato, having acquired a tender full of LNWR coal, moves off to the turntable to prepare to go off shed. As the Geordies head to the water column queue, the 1:20 p.m. local off the Tilsley line rattles over the point work. At 1:30, the down home is off, heralding the arrival of the pig train from Ortsall Lane. 8 minutes later, the signals come off for the 138 return working to Manchester via Atherton and Tilsley. This circuitous route hoping to garner extra traffic at the expense of speed in these less hurried times. As the ex-pig train wagons are brought into the yard, a number of steam shed moves are carried out. With the loop cleared, the Northeastern Class T can get on its way, picking up its brake bands first. This will be a lodging turn for the crew, and they and the engine will be stabled overnight at Plodder Lane Shed, the crew staying in lodgings. By all accounts, they would have had a good time in the local pub in the evening. At least it was assumed they did, as no one could understand a word they said. Waiting coal tank can now make its way to the shed. Some of the pig train wagons are destined for Deansgate, and the 2 o'clock trip sets off with them promptly. Thank you. Back at the station, the 2:10 Kenyan motor train eases into the bay. This is followed at 2:23 by the next Manchester local, this one from the standard direct route via Row Green Junction. At Deansgate, the returning trip sets off back to Crook Street. Half an hour after it arrived, the Kenyan Junction motor train is ready to depart as the Deansgate trip arrives back into the yard.